Hey guys, it's me, Morpheus. It's Carlos. And I always do that swallow. I just noticed that. Every time I say, hey guys, it's me, Morpheus, it's Carlos, I take that half second to swallow, I guess because I know I'm going to be talking for a while. Want to give you guys a quick update, okay? You guys are asking a lot about this case. And, lately I've been clearing my PM box completely every night. But I still get, a good 30, 40 questions in there every night. And at least 5 to 10 of those are about this case here. I've referred to it as, and you guys are too, it's a slider with the magnification lens. That's all this is it's an in-case slider. It doesn't have the roundness of the in-case slider. All right, it's kind of flat. You see the design. It's flat here. Whereas the in-case slider's rounded. I didn't even expect to do this video, but I figure I would just to give you guys a quick update. It's totally flat here, but it is rounded on the back. So it does have that in-case slider design, but it feels different in the hand, okay? I actually like the way this feels. It's rubbery on the bottom, rubbery on the top, and slick in the middle here. Okay, slick in the middle, rubbery up top, rubbery on the bottom. But I noticed that same night I had this, and I take care of my stuff, guys. Look at that. Do you see all those hairlines? And I mean, now I'm getting really nice scratches. You see that one right there is a really nice one. This is the deal with this. I noticed that I had little hairlines, and I'm going, what? Are you kidding me? I don't treat this any different than I do my in-case slider, and I don't have any scratches on that, guys. It's held up really well. This case here, for some reason, it's just really, let's see if we can get something here. There you go. You just saw, I totally just did this. Let me see if I can get that on camera down here. Let me flip this around. I totally just did this. You see that? Let me see. There they go. See it right in the center of the bulbs there? I just did that. This here is like, it scratches really easy, guys. I don't know why that is. After I noticed the first couple hairlines, I said, all right, forget it. The case is great. It does leave marks really super easy. So I just started flicking this inside of my Revo skin. Not my Revo skin. Yeah, my iSkin Revo clip. All right, that, you guys know, it totally just holds the phone up here. It doesn't even come near the camera lens, so you guys don't have to worry about that. But it does hold the phone secure. I'm like, you know what? Forget it. If it's going to scratch, it's going to scratch. All this is held up really well. You guys see no scratches on this at all. I kind of wish that this whole design was this. You know what I mean? This rubbery texture here. I did try to use this inside my Moshi pouch a couple times. And it is Moshi, guys. I totally got an email from the company. They're watching. Okay? They saw the review. They loved what I did on it. But the way it goes is, it's a Moshi pouch, not a Moshi pouch. I've been calling it Moshi. It's a Moshi pouch. That word I couldn't figure out was like Terra, oh my God. I can't even think of how that went. Terra standing for trillion and Hedrum as in, I don't know. They gave me a whole explanation, and it was great. It kind of made a little sense. You know, it was cutesy the way they went about that. But it's a Moshi pouch. I tried to use this inside the Moshi pouch, but it is a little rubbery. So it did stick on the way in, and it stuck on the way out. And it was just enough for me to go, forget it. We're using the iSkin clip. It does dance a little bit forward and back in the clip. It does dance a little bit up and down. But I've been using it. I like that clip. I like, using these cases in there. It totally works for me. I still have that SGP screen shield on here, guys. Just give this a quick wipe. Yes, see that. This case hasn't been off here all day, by the way, guys. So whatever's in here when I pull this out is what's in here when it comes out, okay? I have been given the top just a wipe. And there it is, guys. That screen shield is still immaculate. There isn't any nicks, any little... And I expect it because I'd rather be on the screen itself. I'd rather be on the screen itself than on... I was in vibrate, too. I'd rather be on the screen itself than on, on the I'd rather be on the shield than on the screen. And those colors just pop, really. I don't know, again, if that product really works or not, but it's fantastic. All right, I just want to give you guys a quick update. Let me go ahead and pull this out, because I do want you guys to see this again, how this works. You know, again, you guys can kill this video. You totally just pull it apart. There you go. And real quick, I just noticed something. That screen shield, when I did it, remember when I did it inside the Insidio? It did pick up my old Switch Easy on the corner. It did pick up. Now, if you guys notice this, this totally lays over the bezel. But I mean, by like a couple millimeters there. It doesn't just basically little bit cover that bezel. It covers it completely. All right, you guys see how much of that is literally hidden under the bezel? Watch this back piece here. Let me go ahead and pull it apart a little bit. Okay, watch that back piece. You guys see how much of that gets covered. All right, my screen shield hasn't gotten picked up at all. My screen shield hasn't gotten nicked at all. There it is. All right, so that screen shield does leave a little millimeter on each edge, little bit across the top and a little bit across the bottom, and I guess it does that for, you know, those slider purposes like that. You see what I mean? I think if I had a Switch Easy on it, totally would have picked up. Totally would have. But I mean, that's a really nice lay on the table design. It's flat. It works great. This is the Griffin Ike. Clarify. I'm sorry. There's my back. There's my back. Little bit of dust. Let me see. Yep. I just picked that up. Little dot right there on my finger. Here's the front. And I do have a little bit of mark around the edge here, where I guess that dust has started to build up. Let me see. It's still a little damp on the inside. Let me give this just one wipe. Yep, totally clean. That totally worked. All right, so yeah, this case here is pretty badass, guys. I'm going to cut this video short. This here is that sliding mechanism. Okay, and when I first started doing this, I'm thinking, man, that sucks, because this slider here is totally going to start to wear out my phone up here, and it's going to leave a mark, but it doesn't. I mean, I don't know. Let me see if I can get the bulbs in there. It doesn't, guys. You guys are just going to have to take my word for it. It hasn't. How's that? Not that it won't, but it hasn't. It's a pretty decent design. Again, this is kind of like the slider. You guys are seeing it. There's the top. There's the bottom. Slides together. There's the back. Unslide it. See what I mean? So, I mean, yeah, this case is pretty rock solid. I like it. As you see, I'm using it right now. I go back and forth between this, the in-case slider, the spec, the Pixel Skin. I've been rocking the hell out of that one. I plan on using a different case. You know, I got a pouch that I'm getting ready to do an unboxing on. So, guys, stay tuned to that one, all right? It's me, Morpheus. It's Carlos. I just want to give you a quick update on this. See, let me see if I can do it again. We're totally clean back here, right? You see those marks that I did, by the way, right down here. Let me see. We'll do this right here. Yep, I got a couple more. You guys see, they look like little train tracks right there, right down the center right there. So yeah, I mean, guys, I would rather 100% this screen, this shield here, the cover gets scratched than the phone, okay? So yeah, this thing is doing its job. I'd rather it had been this material, because check this out. See this bottom? Now I'm holding the phone up and scratching down here. See what I mean? That thing is durable. So yeah, I kind of wish it had been made out of this completely, but it wasn't. It was made really super slick, really super shiny, and there they go, guys. You're going to wind up with a lot of hairline scratches on here, but the case is pretty decent. It does what it's supposed to do very well. That whole camera function. Let me see if I can get this on camera real quick. Let's see. Here we go. Let's bring this up here. There's the iClear. Let's see. That's really super close to, guys. So that's what it looks like without it. That's what it looks like with it. So I mean, I hope this does it justice, guys. There it is without it. Kind of fuzzy. There it is with it. You can see those words down here totally clear up. One more time for you guys. Ready? There it is without it. See, it's fuzzy. And there it is with it. So yeah, this thing totally really works. It really does. It's simple in design. It works very well. And I like it. I do. It's not the perfect case. It's not the greatest case, but it does what it does very well. All right, guys, it's supposed to be, you know, a little camera lens, and it does that. The design will remind you of the NK slider. Really nice design. We all know we like that slider. So, all right, guys, it's me, Morpheus. It's Carlos. I'm going to go ahead and sign out here. Emails are banging. I'm wondering what's in here. Let me take a quick look, guys. Emails just keep coming. Ah. Did I post something there? Has it applied to your thread? You subscribed? Huh. Alright, guys, yeah, I got some kind of post coming up. Hello, Morpheus. Has just replied to your thread. So I'll check that out now. Alright, guys, it's me, Morpheus. It's Carlos. Let me go ahead and sign out. I'm going to do another unboxing. This wasn't really an unboxing, but I'm going to go ahead and do an unboxing. And we'll see what we wind up with. Alright, guys, I may have 1-2 videos for you guys tonight. And there it is, guys. Peace out. Alright.